understand how McDonald's expanded its operations worldwide is essential to know how the company was first established. As McDonald's says themselves, the story started with the two brothers Dick and Mac McDonald that had a restaurant in San Bernardino, California. Once Ray Kroc stepped inside, he was amazed by the effectiveness of their operation. When the brothers were looking for a new franchising agent, Kroc saw the opportunity, and in 1955 he founded McDonald's System Inc., and 6 years later he bought the exclusive right to the McDonald's name. Ray Kroc envisioned a unique philosophy: in business for yourself, but not by yourself, as he wanted both franchisees and suppliers to buy into his vision. His philosophy was based on the simple principle of a three-legged stool. One leg was McDonald's franchisees, the second McDonald's suppliers, and the third McDonald's employees. McDonald's first established its restaurant all over the USA in 1976. Their first international franchise opened in British Columbia, followed by another in Costa Rica later that year. From that moment on, McDonald's rapidly expanded worldwide throughout three new continents as stores launched in Japan, the Netherlands, and Australia. In 1979, they added South America to the list of continents by opening its first restaurant in Brazil, and in 1992 they reached world domination by being present in all continents by opening its first restaurant in Morocco. As for McDonald's internationalization process, things have been rough at the beginning for the Great Golden M. At first, the company thought it would succeed by expanding throughout specific regions, applying their American menus all over the place. They failed as revenue did not come through. Their menu was criticized by locals because cultural differences showed that tastes, preferences, and religion affected food choices in different places all over the world. As soon as the managers realized that, McDonald's applied the famous think globally, act locally, and made it their trademark of internationalization strategy, as the transnational strategy fits McDonald's best. As from that moment on, McDonald's has divided the world into geographical regions and applied cross-cultural knowledge to their franchises over the world. Their franchise business model made it possible for McDonald's to let their franchisers comply with the local customers, to come up with ideas to appeal to the local public, to change the decor in different restaurants across the globe, or to deliver specific actions in specific regions. As for the market strategy, the four P's of product, promotion, place, and price are both standardized and localized, as can be seen in the diagram. Apparently, McDonald's has experienced great success in their internationalization process, because it now has 36,000 restaurants in more than 100 countries all across all continents. McDonaldization has even become a term invented by sociologist Jörg Richard to describe a society adopting to the characteristics of a food restaurant, naming the principles of the fast food restaurants are coming to dominate more and more sectors of recent ideas about the worldwide homogenization of cultures due to globalization.
Having that said, let's pass to study what are McDonald's main competitors in Colombia. So in order to study this or to answer this question, it is pertinent to study the industry first, which is the burger industry. Based on the statistics, burger consumption in Colombia was 3.8 billion Colombian pesos in 2018 and was the top search food in Uber Eats. Moreover, Euromonitor suggests that by 2021 there will be 1,529 burger restaurants available for consumers, a 10% increase compared to 2019. So this is an industry that currently is overwhelmed with a vast number of options available for fast food and thus burgers. Consumers have many options to satisfy their needs of burger. Therefore, we can conclude that the burger industry is in constant growth alongside with the middle class population increase that pushes consumption and thus the economy. Now, McDonald's currently faces two types of competitors. The first one are direct competitors that offer the same kind of product with the same business model, hamburgers and auto service. But there is There are also other kinds of fast food restaurants that are also competitors for McDonald's, that are substitutes or alternatives for consumers whilst deciding whether to eat hamburgers or pizza, sushi, hot dog, arepas, kebabs, tacos, and so on. So McDonald's is in a highly competitive market and has to offer an aggregated value in order to stand out. Nonetheless, let's review the first group of direct competitors of McDonald's, which are the ones that offer burgers and auto service. Based on an article of Colombian newspaper La República, McDonald's dominates the Colombian hamburger fight by having 26% of the market share, alongside with El Corral that has 24% of the market share. Different to these restaurants, there are also other restaurants which are Presto, Burger King, and El Rodeo that have market share of 8.3, 5.1, and 1.8 consequently. The remaining 35% is held by other burger restaurants with a smaller market share. So, McDonald's is dominating the Colombian hamburger market. Great quality burgers are in the remaining 35%, such as Home Burgers, which has had a great increase in its market share, as well as Sierra Nevada and La Hamburguesería, which have shown all the three great performance over the past few years, but it's not enough yet to consider a risk for McDonald's market share. McDonald's is dominating the Colombian hamburger market alongside with El Corral. So where does the company stand compared to the competition? As mentioned previously, currently McDonald's stand as the leader compared to the competition. But it is a tough fight because alongside McDonald's there is El Corral, which have the 24% market share that is 2% less than McDonald's. So we can see it's evident that McDonald's is the leader of the industry.
So, what were the key factors for McDonald's success in Colombia? As the president of the Caribbean division stated, Colombia is one of the most important markets in the region for McDonald's, not only because of its size, but also because of the legal guarantees and the progress that McDonald's operations have been shown. And more important, the launching of important products and the focus on their customers make McDonald's a brand that is very close to Colombians. These factors are based on the known adaptation as well as innovation of the company. They came up with a variety of services and products catering to the needs of the consumer market that is diverse, basing their offerings on customer demand, adjusting the business to market trends, and unifying the direction to strive to have fast and family-oriented services, cleanest and customer-based products. Colombia has made strong efforts to open up to foreign investment since the 90s and has continued enhancing its investment framework, simplifying procedures and removing unnecessary administrative burdens to investors as part of the National Development Plan. Statutory barriers to foreign direct investments are the lowest in the region and lower than the OECD average. In 2018, in world foreign direct investment stock reached 57% of the GDP, higher than the Latin American region average. In 1994, and faced with a new economic openness model in Colombia, a team of experts was sent to the country to take samples from all kinds of suppliers and also to study its market target. Having confidence in Colombia's economic recovery, the strategic priorities of the company were to achieve continuous growth in the large middle class segment, provide the customer with special attention and high value products, and effective marketing of the McDonald's name on a national scale. McDonald's managed to open a great number of restaurants with a format that produced a radical change in the way fast food restaurants are run by incorporating additional services such as playground, parking lots, and employment for young university students. Thus, the format had an impact of the consumption habits on Colombians. One milestone that assured McDonald's success in Colombia was also in 2007 when Arcos Dorados assumed the exclusive operation of McDonald's in Colombia. Part of Arcos Dorados' task was to reverse McDonald's Battle Star in Colombia, gearing the best locations in the country for the restaurant. McDonald's launched its McProtectados strategy, an initiative that implemented the highest biosafety standards to provide a reliable experience for our customers and a safe work environment for their employees.